داود جيوش نے، اسحاق جيوش نے، يحيى جيوش نے، مگر children be given of them Jewish names. Why? Because these are the names of the righteous servants of God. We are not ashamed to give these names to our children. But the fact remains that Allah chose them. He sends prophets after prophets to them to do a certain job of work. They didn't do it. They didn't fulfill their obligation. So a Jew among the Jews, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, he is telling his people according to the so-called Injil, the New Testament of the Christians. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is made to say, and the kingdom of God, this high position, this honor, this place, will be taken away from you and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof. This position that you are holding will be taken away from you and given to somebody else. And who that somebody else will be? A nation that will produce fruits. You don't produce fruits, cut it off. Burn it. Trees that don't bear fruit, what do you do with the trees? Just an ornament, do nothing, chop it off. Useless. Occupying valuable space. You too, you will look at it, chop it off. Replace you. So Hazrat Isa alayhi salam told the Jews that you will be displaced by somebody else. And there is another law seems to be at work, that when he displaces one group of people by another, almost invariably that people who displaces you, who replaces you, is a nation, is a community that you have been looking down for. That's Allah's punishment. When you look down on the mosque, he makes them to sit on your head. You're looking down upon the Bantus, then one day Allah will make them to sit on your head. You look down upon the Bushman, the Hottentot, you can make them to sit on your head. The people you are looking down upon, you say, make them to sit on your head. Now you feel something. You still feel that fear whether they're macerate, you are less than that. Now, I tell you, useful now. In Syria, the Muslims, the Sunnis, people like you and me, we are the Sunnis. We say we follow the Sunnah, the example of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Sunnis, 80% of the people are Sunnis. They rule Syria. They led a certain group of people called the Alawites. Alawites. Syrians, but they belong to a different community. They believe that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam is God. Same like the Christians say Jesus is God, they say Hazrat Ali is God. And the Sunnis, they exploited these people. As we exploit the African. They exploited them. They won't ever send their sons to the army. That's what is low down people. Low caste. The Alawites. Let them go and join the army. Let them go and join the police force. Our sons, they will do business. Our sons, they're going to become black and professional. Okay. Who will do the Navy job? The Alawites. The Alawites. Who's going to work in your house? The girls that work in your house? The Alawites. They work in your house. There's many looking after your children. You're a good relationship. Now you've got slaves. Slaves in the days, in the 20th century, you've got slaves working for you. They are your slaves. Allah turned the tables. That less than 20% of the people are now ruling 80% of the Syrians. I mean, you can imagine it. Yes, Tabdil Qawm Ayah. There is a law at work. Why won't you learn? You don't do the job. You don't do your hands. No, you don't do your hands. You don't do the police. You don't do the John Gandhi. No, this guy will be the blue guy. The blue castle. Right. So now he's got the army, the weapons, one day coup d'etat, toppling the government, and he's now set in position. The 20% is ever there to subjugate him. Keep you down. 80% is keeping 80% down. Allah Bari Ta'ala, in his wisdom, he displaced the Jews. By who? By the Arabs. These Jews were looking down upon the Arabs for 3,000 years. They said, you see, Father Abraham, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he had two wives, Sarah and Hagar. They say, the Jews, that Sarah was his legitimate wife. He entered into a contract with her. But Hagar, this is Hajarah, was a bond woman, a slave woman. She was actually a princess of Egypt. The ruler of Egypt, he presented her to him. But the Jews, because of their hatred, they say she was a bond woman, a slave woman. As such, her children come from nothing. They call the Arab Hagarines, children of Hagar, Hagarines. And the religion is Hagarism. This is the incentive to speak about the Arabs, the cousin, and the religion, Hagarism. For 3,000 years, they were looking down. I think there might be some windows open on the top. There is a glass coming directly. It's not air conditioned. I think it must be some windows. Is it with a floor on the top? Because I can see the darkness coming right on my head. I don't know how long I'm going to last with this cold. You know, it's all about the humidity. Yeah. Oh, yes. There is a lot of difference. If you go with the camera, you will go a little bit much lighter. So they were looking down upon the Arab cuts. Good for nothing. In the sight of the Jews, the Arabs are good for nothing. Barbarian, illiterate, only people. And Allah Bari Tala chooses them. And makes them to sit on the heads of the Jews. But now once he sits on the pedestal, he is not forever. He has to be good, to do the fruits. He doesn't do the fruits. Yes, he is substituting a place among the people. That's the law, Allah. Why don't people learn? That's the law. So the Muslims spread out. They went as far as Spain, as far as the Atlantic coast. They will conquer Spain and they rule that country for 800 years. Muslims, the European nation, Spain, for 800 years. No Christian nation has ever ruled Muslims for that period of time. Did you know that? The longest that they ever ruled was in Mozambique, the Portuguese. See, Mozambique is a Muslim territory. Even today, 60% of the people of Mozambique are Muslims. Here, next door. This place was an Arab outpost, trading post. And there was a governor there when the Portuguese came along and conquered them. There was a governor by the name of Musa bin Beg. Musa bin Beg was the governor of that territory. When the Portuguese, with his superior gunpower, he came and knocked hell into them and conquered the place. Whose place? Musa bin Beg. They couldn't say Musa bin Beg, so they said Mozambique. That's how the name Mozambique comes about. The Muslims went in crossed the strait, the sea between Africa and Spain, and landed at the place Jabal. They called that mountain Jabal of Tariq. Tariq was the commander who crossed over from Africa to Spain, and the place where they landed, they called that mount Jabal of Tariq. Now, the Westerners, they call it Gibraltar. Jabal of Tariq, they said Gibraltar. The Muslims went as far as the Philippines, where the trading post there, Ma'mamullah, by the help of Allah, so he's there. Ma'mamullah, with a Manila. Muslim. The longest that the Christians ever ruled Muslims was in Mozambique for 500 years. They ruled their motherland, Indonesia, for 300 years, the Dutch. 300 years. Longest was in Mozambique, 500 years. The Muslims ruled Spain for 800 years. What were they doing? Muslims were having a jolly good time all along. As the African is having now, here, the white man, same thing, the Muslim was the same position. In Spain for 800 years he had it. The Africana is here only for 300 years. He's having the good time, the hunger and the it's nice things here. He's having it only for 300 years. The Muslims had it for 800 years. And they're listening to the dire warnings of the Quran. Allah is one of them. He's warning us all. All times. The warnings are eternal. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ Before that, سَكَمْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ جَنَّاتِ الْعُيُونَ عن ترك من جنات وعيون وزوء ومكان كريم ونعمة كانوا فيها فاتحين كذلك أورثناها قوما آخرين فما بقت عليهم السماء والأرض وما كانوا منذرين بيرد من الصلاة بيرد من القرآن in the Salat, they read. During the Tali, they read. And they read the Tilawat in the homes, they read. These are Arabs. They understood what they were reading. It was for them, in our case, we have a lame excuse for saying, we don't understand. It's an excuse. We don't understand what we read. Allah has given a warning, but this is like water on Dutch back, because we didn't know what the warning is where about. So now, I want to put you in a dangerous situation. I said, look, you get the translation. So we won't have any more excuses. That's why you are afraid. Don't lie. You are in deeper trouble. Yes. Now you are released, and I'm telling you this, right? And if you don't hit the warning, double trouble. Rather be in single trouble. Just say, I didn't know. You can think and get away with that. The Arab is reading this in his own mother tongue. And Allah is warning him. Kam tarakum jannati wa uyun. So how many were the gardens and the fountains are left behind? Wazum wa makamin kareem. And cornfields and monumental buildings. Wa ni'matin kanu fiha fakihin. And wealth and the amenities of life in which they took so much delight. Kathalika. أورثناها قوما آخرين that other people were made to inherit these things فما بقت عليهم السماء والأرض وما كانوا منذرين and neither the heavens nor the earth shed a tear for them nor was respite given to them anymore they read it but when they read it you know they're thinking about Egyptians they are thinking about the Egyptians the food of Pharaoh you know Allah look at them The garden they had and the fountain they had and the monumental building, the pyramids and the sphinx. Ooh, what must they have? And all things, everything they had, riches, one of the most richest civilized nations at the time of the time was Egypt. And the food, he didn't hear the warning. And that means plague after plague, warning after warning. He didn't hear Jubilallah destroyed him in the Red Sea, drowned him, and his horse and his troops, they drowned him in the Red Sea. You see that fool? He didn't learn. See what Allah did to him? The fool doesn't know that he is in the firing line now. When he's reading, he is in the firing line.